The sports one was very effective because South Africa was very, very, white South Africa was very sports mad, let me put it that way. And the fact that they were now being ostracized. It started with a coloured cricketer. He was a very good cricketer, but he was not allowed to travel on a South African team. The Maoris in the New Zealand started putting pressure, saying if we go to South Africa, we must be allowed to go as New Zealanders, not as Maoris, or have a special thing. So those were the sorts of things that started making the impact. The Olympic Games, South Africa was excluded. We had a South African non-racial Olympic movement, and they were doing, so these were offshoots. They were not under the control of the ANC. We liaised with all of these people, but there were people themselves involved who were dealing with all of these different issues. The cultural boycott, of course, took off tremendously, and a lot of people refused to come. So it was a thing that moved with the times, with the situation as it happened. And it didn't involve only the ANC. We supported it. But it was people's consciences across the globe, whether it was Bono or it was somebody else.